Going to attempt to build a non-circulating hydroponic system out of a gel pack container. It's fairly decent size. I got this from Sam's Club. This, you know, locks in place, but if you line it up, you can pull it off like that part of it. And you can see that a 3-inch net pot fits perfectly. So what I'm going to do, the other one I hand cut up, I'm going to use I bought this 3-inch hole saw. So it should be perfect for that. But one thing I did notice on this one, I thought this was a white container. But as you can see, it's, you know, lets quite a bit of light through. So I'm going to paint this first. Actually, I'll drill the hole first and then I'll paint this. So I'm getting ready to drill out the lid. I put a couple pieces of Gorilla tape since the lid turns before I do that. And there's a little hole right here in the center. That's where I want to put my center bit. Main thing with the hole saw is once you get the center hole started, switch it to reverse. Alright, we'll switch it to reverse. Let's see. There we go. A nice clean cut. And this should fit just right. Yep, it's perfect. Okay, so got this painted, and comes off there. You can see now that can't see a hand through it, so it's blocking light a lot better. What I'm going to put in it is a Carbonero. It's a pepper created by Tony Sherwood. Three-way cross between a Indian carbon Buchalukia with a 7-pot yellow and an orange habanero. I'm growing three of these, so this is kind of my sacrificial one. I've had it in a deep water culture system, so it's got a pretty good root system already, so I'm not really sure the best way to do this, because I think ideally with a Kratky type system you'd want roots barely coming out of the bottom and then submerge those and kind of let them grow down. But since I already have a bunch, this would actually be hitting the bottom of the container, and I don't know if that would cause a problem, if they would drown. So I'm going to take a gamble and prune these roots back to maybe there, just so it'll be just below the waterline. And I've got some pre-washed clay pebbles, so I want to fill around here to block out any light that can come in from the top. Anyway, that's what I've got, and I guess I could take it out of this other cup. So I cut a bunch of these things out. I got the roots hanging out about as well as I can get them. So now the tricky part's going to be to see the right water level. So what I'm going to do is kind of pre-fill this, and then when I get closer, I'm going to put the plant down inside and attempt to see where the water is hitting the roots, and then I'm going to fill in the clay pebbles around it. So I already mixed up some Masterblend, doing 3 grams of the Masterblend and 3 calcium nitrate, 2 Epsom salt. In a gallon is a ppm about between 1,000 and 1,100, and I adjusted my pH to around 6.2, 6.3. So I'm going to go ahead and pour some out what I need. I don't know if this will work, but I'm going to drop this guy down in here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, those are in there now. So, so now I just go ahead and fill up these pebbles. Should be good to go. So I'm gonna stick this under my 400 watt light and just check on it every week, see how it does. I'll post some follow-up video updates on show how it's doing. And if you like this video, please like it on YouTube and subscribe to my channel. And thank you very much for watching.